If you're looking to install Windows 10 on your system in 2025 with simple steps, this video is for you. So without any delay, let's get started.
First, open your browser and search for Microsoft Software Download. Click on the official Microsoft website. Here you'll find all available Windows versions, but keep in mind, Windows 7 and Windows 8 ISOs are no longer available since they've been discontinued. Currently, only Windows 10 and Windows 11 can be downloaded. However, there's an important notice for Windows 10. After October 14, 2025, it will no longer receive free software updates. So, I highly recommend saving the Windows 10 ISO now, because after discontinuation, it may not be available for download anymore. Also, note that Windows 11 currently offers version 24H2, and an update to 25H2 is expected around September or October. Meanwhile, Windows 10 has version 22H2 available, so keep that in mind while downloading. Now, let's move on to the next step. You'll see options for Windows Installation Assistant and Media Creation Tool, but the ISO file isn't directly available for download. To access it, click the three dots in your browser, go to More Tools, and open Developer Tools. Make sure device emulation is enabled, then refresh the page. Scroll down to Edition and select Multi-Edition, then click Confirm. Next, choose your preferred language and confirm again. Now, select your system's bit type. If you have 2 GB of RAM, go with 32-bit. But if you have 4 GB or more, select 64-bit. Once you click, the ISO download will start immediately. Search for Rufus and click on the first link. Scroll down a bit and select Rufus Standard to proceed. After downloading both files, select Rufus, right-click on it, and run it as an administrator. Then, drag and drop the Windows 10 ISO file into Rufus. Next, insert a USB drive with at least 8 GB of storage. In the Partition Scheme section, you'll see two options, MBR and GPT. To check your disk's partition style, open the Start menu, search for Disk Partition, and open it. Right-click on your disk, go to Properties, and navigate to the Volumes tab. Here, you'll find your partition style. In my case, it's GPT. Once you've confirmed your partition style, click Start. A pop-up for User Experience Mode will appear. If you want to customize the installation, you can, but I'll proceed with the official setup. Next, you'll see a warning that your USB drive will be formatted. Click OK to confirm, then OK again. Now the bootable creation process begins. This step may take some time, so just let it finish. Once Rufus has finished creating the bootable drive, close the program and restart your system. During reboot, press your boot key to enter the boot menu and select your USB drive. After a few seconds, the Windows installation screen will appear. Click Next, then Install Now. After a brief wait, the license agreement will appear. Check Accept License and click Next. Choose Custom Install, Windows Only, where you'll see all available partitions. In my case, I don't have extra partitions to save, but if you do and want to keep them, only delete the small MB-sized partitions. If you've renamed your important drives other than the C drive, their names will be displayed here. To ensure correct selection, note down the size of your C drive and other important partitions before starting the installation. After deleting unnecessary partitions, select the C drive and click Next. The file copying process begins. Once all checks are completed, the restart screen will appear. Click Restart and remove the USB drive. Now, proceed with the initial setup. Select your region and click Next. Choose your keyboard layout, then click Next again. Skip the second keyboard layout selection. When prompted for an internet connection, select I don't have internet and continue with the limited setup. Enter your username and click Next. You can set a password if needed, but I'll skip that step. Next, adjust privacy settings. I usually disable all options before clicking Accept. When the Cortana setup appears, select Not Now. After a few minutes, Windows 10 is fully installed and ready to use, and that's it. If you enjoy this type of content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I'll see you in the next one.